watch the sun rise in your eyes, and I've seen the tears fall like the rain. You've seen me fight so brave and strong, and you've held my hand when I'm afraid. We've watched the seasons come and go, we'll see them come and go again. But in winter's chill or summer's breeze, one thing will not be changing. We will dance when the sun is shining in the pouring rain. We'll spin and we'll sway, and we will dance when the January becomes a hurricane. The music will play, and I'll take your hand and hold you close to me, and we will dance. Sometimes it's hard to hold you tight. Sometimes we feel so far apart. Sometimes we dance as one and feel the beating of each other's heart. Some days the dance is slow and sweet. Some days we're bouncing off the walls. No matter how this world may turn, our love will keep us from falling. And we will dance when the sun is shining in the pouring rain. We'll spin and we'll sway, and we will dance when the January becomes a hurricane. The music will play, and I'll take your hand and hold you close to me, and we will dance.
seen. We have gathered here today to witness the marriage of Greg and Karen, friends and family of yours that you have loved for a very long time. And so it is with great joy in our hearts that we are here today to remember that Jesus' first miracle was the miracle at Cana of Galilee, which it was a wedding celebration. And they wanted the wedding celebration to not end, to continue. And Jesus turned the water into wine. This is God's plan. The man and the woman should be joined together in holy marriage. And you who have known them, some of you are here since they took their very first steps. And you remember the first sounds that they made, mothers. You remember that, you father. You remember that first day they went to kindergarten and the day they completed first grade. At the time they got their first scrape on their knees and had the feelings hurt. You were with them to love them and support them and encourage them and bring them to this point in their lives. You remember when they came home and said, I found the love of my life, and they were in the seventh grade or the eighth grade. You remember that. And the love that God has placed between these two is nothing to be compared with anything else in their life. For God has given them a love that is kind and is patient and does not seek its own way and is understanding, seeking first to understand rather than to be understood. Karen and Greg have come before us this day as those who are committed to live the rest of their lives together. And what a holy moment for us as their family and their friends to celebrate with them. And so now, as we are here, if we could ask them together their declaration of intention to marry, because I asked you now in the presence of God and these who are here today to declare your intention to enter into union with each other through the grace of Jesus Christ, who calls you into union with himself as acknowledged in your baptism. So Greg, I ask you, will you have Karen to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage, to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
Absolutely.
Karen, I ask you, will you have Greg to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Last evening, we were here together, and we heard the blessings of their family, and we knew that behind the family and friends' blessings of last night stood all of you and many others. And so today, it is with great joy that I understand that they have the affirmation and the encouragement from you, their friends and family, to enter this union together. So I ask you, who gives this woman Karen to be married to this man, Greg? This is an incredible moment for all of us today. So let's just take this moment to thank God. Eternal Father, you are the one who created us, who designed us, who has guided us to this moment in our lives. We thank you for all the decisions that Greg and Karen have made to bring them to this point. And we ask that you would continue to help their love to flourish and grow in this time and in this day, as they always remember you are the one who began a good work in them. And you are the one who will continue this until the day of Jesus Christ. We thank you for their faithful commitment to you, to be all that you have designed them to be. And we ask again for special blessings upon Greg and Carol. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. As we take the vows. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Greg.
Take you, Karen.
To be my wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward.
For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
In the name of God, I can take the breath to be my husband, to have the hope from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
love, cherish, until we're parted by death. This is my sorrow now. The wedding rings are an outward, invisible signal. A sign for all the world to know that Karen and Greg have committed themselves to each other. And as it is a complete circle, it represents the unending love of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit for all of us. But for them too today, it symbolizes the love that they have given them to each other by God. Join me as we ask God's blessing upon the rings. Father, we ask your blessings upon the rings, upon these who give and these who receive. Bless Karen. Bless Greg, Father. As this ring will become a symbol of the joy and the love and the contentment and the security and the provision that you have made for them for the rest of their life. Guide them and guard them and keep them as they exchange the rings and live in the life of the promise and the vows that they have made this day. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we thank you. Amen. Karen, I give you this ring. As a sign of my vow. And with all that I have. And all that I am. I honor you. In the name of the Father. And of the Son. And of the Holy Spirit.
and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Greg, I give you this ring as a sign of my vow, in all that I am, in all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
At this time, we would like to ask Gabriel and Daniel and Robert to join us here. Your mother and father have exchanged vows and they have exchanged rings this day. And now we would ask you, as family and friends, are you willing to live your life in such a way that you will encourage them and strengthen them and help in every way you can to establish their marriage as a place where God will reign supreme, where there will be love and laughter in your home, where there will be sharing and communication, where you will in every way endeavor to support them in this wonderful journey that all of you are taking together now. If you're willing to go do that, what do you say?
We will.
Yes.
Yes.
Father, we ask for your covering, your protection on this family that you have put together. Guard them, guide them, strengthen them as they build a household of faith together. Bless these, Gabriel, Daniel, and Robert, as they support their mom and dad, as they encourage them, and as they live the life that you have called them to live. Yes, it's such a blessing on these five who are here this day as a new family. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now that Karen and Greg have exchanged vows and rings, I now pronounce that they are husband and wife together. And Greg, you may kiss your bride. Oh, Father, we pray that their lives would be so full of the joy that you have placed in their hearts this day, that laughter will ring from the rooftops, and you will continue to encourage them in their relationship together as they grow in love and as they grow in faith with you. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' holy, precious name, amen. Now, as Karen and Greg light the unity candle together, may you be reminded that the two candles represent the two families that they have come from to establish a new family, a new home. So if together we could remember the root words from Ruth and God's holy word, in which he said, whether thou goest, I will go. And whether thou lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people shall be my people, and thy God, my God. Thank you.
hearts are full today. Your generous goodness, your gracious presence here has overwhelmed us with the realization that you have placed Karen and Greg together, not only for this moment, but for our lifetime. We ask again that you would go forth before both of them and make crooked places straight, that you would open the gates of iron and give them opportunities to minister together in your name. Oh, Father, again, establish their home in peace and love and joy with you as the head of their home. Father, thank you for them. Bless them, we all pray together. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
is my great pleasure to introduce for the very first time Mr. and Mrs. Greg Tarr.
Thank you. When I am down and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burden be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and settle while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me to more than I can be.
You are here to stay. begin to understand everything about you. Tells me I'm your man. I live my life to be with you. No one can do the things you do. Anything you want, you got it. Anything you need, you got it.
Out of Thank you. 'cause I finally found someone who really cares. You held my hand when it was cold, when I was lost.
Stories, but they all sound too good to be true. You've heard about a place called home, but there doesn't seem to be one for you. So one more night you cry yourself to sleep with the beat of a heart when love takes you home. While you're sleeping, someone else is dreaming too, counting down the days until they hold you close and say, I love you. And like the rain that falls into the sea, in a moment, what has been is lost in what will be when love takes you in. Everything changes. A miracle starts with the beat of a heart. This love to lose its hold when love takes you in. changes. A miracle starts with the beat of a heart. When love takes you home and says you belong here, the loneliness ends and a new takes you in for good. When love takes you in.
Every step I make. hearts that...
Wait a minute. I'm giving her away? I don't get even 4 sheep, maybe. 2 goats, surely. 1 camel? Surely you can spare 1 camel. 1 cow, then. 1 lonely cow. Or at least 1 cow blanket. Surely you can spare a cow blanket.
I'll be a fool.
Some days we're bouncing off the walls.
No matter how this world may turn, our love will keep us from falling, and we will dance when the sun is shining in the pouring rain. We'll spin and we'll sway, and we will dance when the gentle breeze becomes a hurricane. The music will play, and I'll take your hand and hold you close to me, and we will dance. Take your hand and hold you close to me.